So what does Karmakanda refer to? Enjoy materially, but in a pious way. That's not the intention of Vyasadeva to present Karmakanda section of the Vedas, but that is what people understand Karmakanda to mean. This is the wrong understanding of Karmakanda. What is wrong understanding Karmakanda? Oh, I can enjoy materially in a pious way. But Bhagavata teaches Nivritti Marga, not Pravritti Marga. Pravritti Marga is trying to enjoy in pious way. Nivritti Marga is give up material enjoyment altogether. Just like you see in pious Hindu families, they all understand taking intoxication is bad, it's sinful, very bad. They all understand. But when it comes to taking coffee, not so bad. Not so bad. It's okay. So much so that one person was arguing with me, what is wrong in taking coffee? Why do you say coffee is intoxicant? It has come to this level now. So this is the problem with the Pravritti Marga. Nivritti Marga is thoda chalega. That is not Nivritti Marga. That is tendency of people in the Pravritti Marga. Nivritti Marga is 100% stop all sinful activities. 10%. So coming back to Chetodarpana Marjanam, cleansing of the heart when you execute Bhakti Yoga, not only sinful reactions are nullified, but even the tendency for material enjoyment, both pious and impious ways, are gradually destroyed, cleansed away. Then what happens after Chetodarpana Marjanam? When sufficient cleansing has taken place, then Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapanam. The blazing fire of material existence is extinguished. That means one gets relief from all suffering due to past reactions. No more suffering. No more suffering from sinful reactions. Neither one is obliged to act in a pious way for material enjoyment. Even those reactions are gone. Bhava. Bhava means is material existence. So in material existence, there are two kinds of reactions. Reactions due to my past sinful activities and reactions due to my past pious activities. So general understanding is pious activities are good. You enjoy the reward of having performed pious activities by enjoying life in a pious way. Birth in a good family, earning money in an honest way, and living a good life, pious life. Good education, good bodily beauty, Janma Aishwarya Shruta Shri. So these four are due to past pious activities, correct? So these Kunti Devi, what does she say in her offering of pure devotional prayers to Krishna in first canto, 8th chapter Bhagavatam? Edamana madah puman. It actually leads to people becoming sometimes very proud. Very proud. Taking birth in a good family, definitely aristocratic family means person has performed pious activities in the past. All these are due to past pious activities. Good wealth, good education, good bodily beauty is due to past pious activities. But Kunti Devi says, these are obstacles on the path of pure devotional progress. So, Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapana means completely extinguished the fire of material existence. No more obligation to perform pious activities because of past pious results. No more obligation.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.